played for a little while, but I do like table tennis.
Should be good fun.
We'll see how it goes. At some points, I have a few questions that, like, if I'm losing, I ask you a little tough question, and then if you don't answer it, you lose a point, or I gain a point. So that's my way of, like, trying to get back into the game. So be ready for that. Let's get into it.
Showdown.
For the sportsmanship, and yeah, good luck.
Let's go to war.
This is like the two Englishmen here at the club. This is a big, like, this is important for me as it's important for you. And I'll start with the obvious one. And this one, you know, I'm sure you get this all the time, but I'm from Maidstone. For the Italians who don't know, Maidstone's like...
I don't think a lot of Italians will know
Maidstone. So explain it. It's kind of like, if London is Roma, then Maidstone's like Frosinone and Po. So, just to give you an idea, so I'm from Maidstone. You played for Maidstone.
Yes.
When you were like.
Pretty freaky.
That's a weird coincidence to start, yeah. As we are in Rome now, it's a long way away. When you were like quite young, like 18. Mm-hmm. So, was your first pint, legal pint, also at Ye Old Thirsty Pig on Lower Stone Street in Maidstone? I'm sure it's a question you've had a lot.
It wasn't, but it wasn't far from there.
Was it in, like, was it in Maidstone? Was it in Kent?
It was in Maidstone, yeah.
Was it?
Yeah.
Whereabouts in Maidstone?
Near where a lot of, like, the bars and clubs were. It was a place called, like, Jinx, which was not far from, but not far from there. I know the place you're referring to,
No, because this is, I mean, we may end up cutting this because it is talking about Maidstone United, but it was where your career started.
Yeah.
And I think, if I'm right, as obviously I didn't really do my research for this, but Maidstone United at the time was still playing in Sittingbourne.
Yes.
So not only were you playing lower league, you know, this is non-league level, but for a team that didn't have a home at the time.
No.
So I was just wondering.
In those days, we trained twice a week, so Tuesday and Thursday, in the evening from probably started about 7 for a couple of hours. And then obviously play the game on a Saturday, but we would literally, like, 3 or 4 of us would all jump in a car, we'd like meet at a petrol station, 3, 4, just drive there, get there 1.5 hours before match, drive back. But yeah, there was no sleeping in hotels, pre-match meal or anything. It was just have a sandwich on the way in the car and then get your boots on. And but yeah, it was, yeah, worlds away, but something where I think, because I was so young, you just want to play football. And
but, okay, so...
Yes, a lucky start.
This happened last time against Gonzalo, though, and it went terribly after that. So, do you think much... Do you think back on that time at Maidstone United much, you know, nowadays? Do you ever just sit there and you think about those times, or is it something that... it's so long ago now that you don't really reflect on it so
much? No, I think I do... I do still think about it. I think I will reflect a lot more once I finish, but equally, I never forget that, because I feel like that's what started me on the journey. And I'm very grateful that I think I had a different path to a lot of players. And it was a grounding that I'm very, very fortunate for.
Yeah.
How many serves do we do each?
2 each, I think. So my feeling is that maybe you would still be playing football, loving football.
Yeah.
Whether or not there were, you know, all the attention, all the focus. Is that fair, do you reckon?
Yeah, even when I was younger. Cause, I mean, when I was at Maidstone, I got released from Millwall. So really, my dream of this supposed football lifestyle was...
5-1.
was pretty much...
Hearing the score is not going to be helpful after all, but yeah.
But yeah, when I was at Maidstone, it was almost the dream of being a professional was very low, and it was mainly focused on football, but I knew that I always wanted to play football, so if I went to uni or carried on at Maidstone, I would have carried on playing anyway, so it was a case of I was always going to carry on playing football at whatever level. So, I was just fortunate that I did get a trial at Fulham after, but football was always going to be a part of my life.
And I mean, because this is the thing now, I would say there's perhaps an irony in that you've sort of ended up playing for Manchester United and then Roma, two teams where the attention, the scrutiny, the passion of the fan base is probably rivals anything in the world.
No,
is that fair to say?
Yeah, I think so. I think, I mean, growing up, you hear about both clubs and being lucky enough to be a part of both. But yeah, the fan bases of both are, yeah, like you said, I don't think you could pick two bigger clubs in terms of the fans and the passionate and the global stage. So, very, very lucky.
Let's go Man United related.
Okay.
I think this one's tricky. Vidic or Ferdinand?
I would say Vidic.
So quick. So okay, fine. So
but
I didn't even get a point.
But it's difficult. It's a difficult one, but I think as a defender, born and bred defender, Vidic, he's willing to put his head on the line, whatever it is. And I think both great players, but that diehard attitude, I think, is to have that in a defender. I think that's
like the crucial. You know, once you have that, you can build. Interesting. Yeah. And that you're the one now in this team with a bit more experience. You know, players looking up to you, what you've achieved, what you've done in the game, having to set that example. That must be like quite nice. A nice responsibility.
Yeah. Yeah. It's still feels pretty surreal. I still remember when I was like the young one looking up, and but I know how important it was for me then. To look up and see a role model and see someone doing the right things and maybe giving me a little tip or putting an arm around my shoulder if going through a little bad patch or a rough patch. I mean, because football is just a roller coaster. So, I know how important it is to be there for the young ones. So, and I learned from the best when I was coming through.
So, okay, one other question. If you're playing four at the back here, you're in defence, you want your partner to be Mancini or Banez. And remember, you don't answer. Which I would suggest, just don't answer, and we'll take a point off. Or you can answer and create a selection problem. So it's up to you, but I would say.
What's the score again?
I don't know whether I
can take a point loss or not. I think in that situation, I am going into the manager's office and saying that we play three at the back with all three of us. So I will sacrifice a point for the good of the team, morale, and have all three of us playing.
Okay, that's simultaneously a good answer and I get my point, so I'm happy. I don't know what's, like, yeah, this is, Gonzalo as well, you guys are too clever. Footballers, they're supposed to be like a bit silly, easy to fool in other ways, but it's not true at all, it's not working at all. So anyway, okay, so 5-1 now. The big question. Tea or espresso?
I'm going to say tea, and I know a lot of Italians are not going to be happy
right
at that.
Comments right now on YouTube are just going to be like,
I'll be totally honest, I'm not really either.
Okay.
I'm not really a hot drink lover. Mm-hmm. I mean, if I was going to have a tea, I might have a honey and lemon tea or something, but I'm not really either, and not for any reason, I've not. Coffee I've never really enjoyed, or tea, to be honest. But see, so yeah, I'm more of a cold drink. Me and my brother are the same. We have some of the same things that we don't like, which is often a bit weird to people. But coffees or tea, I'm not really, it's not really me.
What are some of the other things? No, I'm intrigued.
We both don't like cheese. Okay. Again, people going crazy.
Yes. We haven't even gone to vegan carbonara yet, and like people are all going to be crazy, but it's fine. But yeah, okay, that gets me on then to life in Italy. I know it's obviously a bit difficult as COVID has been a problem for large parts of, since you've been here really.
Yeah.
How do you find life in Italy? Have you found you've changed the way you behave in some ways? You know, adapted to some local customs or what?
Yeah, I think, like you say, I think COVID has played havoc on everything, but equally, we was able to sort of get around before it all started and from time to time in between. But yeah, we've found some beautiful places to sort of walk the dogs and some nice restaurants and some nice places to pick up fresh food, etc. So I'd never been to Rome before coming here on loan. It was always on the list of some of the places that we want to go to. But Rome ticks almost, I think, every box that you would want in life. So now on top of coming to a great club, to be able to live in one of the best places I think in the world, that I think people can't argue with, is a very lucky dream.
if take me back to when you were talking about the first loan move, mm-hmm. You know, had you discussed, you know, with your agent or with your family that playing abroad was something you wanted to do, or was it just the opportunity when it arose was the best one for you and you took it, and then coming here quickly fell in love with it? Like, what was the thought process?
Yeah, the whole process, it was a bit of a whirlwind, to be honest. Had I had aspirations to play abroad, I think they were there, but they weren't at the forefront to think, oh, I really want to play abroad before I finish. I think it would have been nice to have done it, but equally I was comfortable if it happened or it didn't happen. But yeah, in terms of all the move, it came around so quickly that it was all in the space of 24, 48 hours. And then as soon as it became a little bit more real, and then obviously spoke to some people at the club as well, it almost just clicked that this was something that I think was too good to turn down, and I didn't want to have any regrets. That's something that I sort of live by a lot, and you know, to be able to take up a new experience and a new challenge, and a demanding one as well.
How are you with like Italian hand gestures?
Hand gestures.
Yeah, that was one of the first things I adopted when I came here. And now I can't, when I go home, when I see my family, they're like, why are you always doing this? And I'm like, it's the only way I know how to really express what I'm feeling.
Yeah, no, it's like something that we noticed straight away when we came, like, oh, a lot of hand gestures, and I guess it's a way of expressing, isn't it? And but yeah, I think we've all started to pick up noticing my wife as well.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, but it's. I like
but
it.
Yeah.
Like, you know, all the hand gestures.
No, I think it's
brilliant.
Good to be able to,
I love to throw it in.
Definitely.
Okay. Match point.
Match point.
Really concentrating. That was a weak effort, I have to say. That was poor from me.
So that's your warm-up game.
Yeah. That's what. Yeah. Exactly. The second game's always the key one.
The
I have
key
to say.
One, yeah.
Another either-or question. I don't know how this works when it's nil-nil.
Well, you get a point if I...
Okay, if you don't answer. I think you can answer this one. Uno or poker?
Wow.
Yeah.
That's...
You weren't expecting that one today either, were you?
No, I wasn't.
You can think a little bit while we start the...
Oh, yes. I'm going to say Uno.
Really?
I love poker. I actually played poker last night with my friends. We just play on an app.
Yeah.
But I think Uno, because it's so simple. Anyone can play. Everyone can play. Like, I'm hoping when I go home, my wife, her mum, her cousin.
Yeah.
And I just think it's in every... And it's so simple as well.
Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, Uno gets the edge.
What, were you playing Uno then? At the bar in Ayur,
yes.
When your deal was getting done with your agents.
Yes.
Okay.
We brought the Uno. We was playing on the plane over, and quite often when people come to us, like, we're playing different games, card games. But yeah, it's, and time just flies as well when you're playing.
Yeah.
It's crazy that it's such a simple game, but you just, I never really played it when I was young, and it's obviously, like, I say, oh, do you want to play? And it's like, oh, kid's game. Like, I never really played it when I was a kid, but now I play it when I'm an adult and I love it.
Yeah. Did you know did you see the photo someone took of you playing
Yeah,
bar?
I got tagged in it actually, which was quite funny because we were sat outside. Well, my friend was having a coffee and I was just having orange juice because I don't want a coffee. And yeah, my other friend was just getting a haircut in the shop next to the, to
right,
the cafe.
Yeah.
So yeah, we were just sat outside. Enjoying the weather and waiting for it all to get completed.
I really enjoyed, as a sort of outsider, I'd like to think I've been half adopted in some ways. I just enjoyed like how much that fired up Roma fans. They were just like, oh, he's joined the Roman culture, like card games in the bar outside. Like, what, he's one of us, Dai,
oh,
Chris.
Definitely. No, all the coffee shops and everything, and I guess the weather is just great that you can able to enjoy so much time outside.
Oh, a classic media team game we often play on random things is like the World Cup of something. So I want you to pick four vegan dishes, your four favorite vegan dishes, and then I'm gonna like draw them together and you have to two semi-finals, you have to pick your winner, and then the final, you have to pick your favorite. So what are like the four, your four favorite vegan dishes? What do you go for usually? It's tough.
Yeah, it's tough enough just going for one, let alone let alone four.
Oh,
I do enjoy a jackfruit curry. With rice and peas, plantain, coleslaw, four works. That's one. Spaghetti bolognese is always a. Is always a winner. What else is there?
9-1.
Maybe this second game doesn't get better.
No, it doesn't. But it's fun, you know, the English people have to stick together. I have to promote you as an all-round athlete. So it's good for your image if you demolish me.
So that's two. I would say my wife makes a nice vegan fish and chips. You know, like in English fish and chips, but she uses the hardened tofu and then she deep fries the...
Oh, really? Yeah.
With the mushy peas, she makes her own tartar sauce to give that. Okay. That's always like...
I think that one might have to win at the end of this game. Yeah.
It's not an everyday have it too often, but... A treat.
Match point.
Oh, match points. Yeah, I've got the three, and then I would say, one more.
No. I tried everything. I used the camera.
Then I would say maybe a stir fry.
Okay.
Different bits in. I do like a rice stir fry.
Okay. All right, I'll pair them up then. So semi-final, stir fry versus the jackfruit curry is one semi-final. The other one then, fish and chips versus the spaghetti bolognese.
Okay.
So you have to choose the two winners there to progress to the final.
Jackfruit curry and...
Stir fry.
Stir fry. Gonna go for the jackfruit curry.
Okay.
And then fish and chips.
Fish and chips made by your wife.
Yeah.
Special recipe,
and she will watch this.
Of course she will, yeah.
And she'll be... No, it's gonna have to be the fish and chips because it's... I can have the spag bowl more often, but the fish and chips is
a special when it
treat.
Comes.
Yeah.
Okay, so now you've got your final fish and chips.
Yeah, I do enjoy the fish and chips, although the jackfruit curry with all the trimmings and the plants in the coleslaw. I'm gonna go for the fish and chips, but as my naughty treats, but then the jackfruit curry with all the trimmings is my go-to favorite meal if okay. I'm a yeah.
So this final has gone to extra time, maybe even penalties,
maybe,
but the jackfruit curry just about steals
yeah.
it. Okay. Final set, decisive.
Okay, final set. Ooh. It's all about a good start.
I always get the good start, and that's as good as it gets for me. But. Oh, it's changing. Okay. The crowd, no, yeah. The crowd were interested for like 1 second. They thought I had a chance and then they were like, no.
I needed that. 3-2.
Oh, no. Throw in another random question while we're at it. Rooney or Scholes?
It's a very, very difficult one. But it's a difficult one. I've always said Scholes when someone's asked me before, just because it's vision.
Yeah.
You play behind him, you just want to give him the ball and you just see him ping different balls everywhere. But Rooney is... Yeah, he's also an idol and someone I played a lot of my career with as well. So that's a tough one. I would always say Scholes, but compare him to Rooney. Waz is probably second.
Yeah.
And very close in terms of got gigs as well. But yeah, Scholes just pips it for me.
Yeah, you said Federer is your idol, but that was more Djokovic-esque. That was just smash angles straight down the line. Damn, okay. So what are we, 9-7 now? 9-6.
9-6. Quick feet.
Replay. Okay.
Federer drop shot. Come on, come on. Didn't get the net there.
Match point.
Whether to play it risky or to try to finish in style.
You have to, yeah, we need like, you need an exclamation point after it, so you need to finish with like a smash. I'd just say like, just unleash.
Unleash.
Yeah, that's my advice. As your opponent. Oh, you didn't. Yes, keep unleashing. I'm like, the pressure's off me now. I've got to 8. I'm more than happy with that. Against like, you've got like 8 inches height on me, 7 inches reach. You're a professional athlete. It's fine, that's good. I've done well. I'm still in this. Oh, I'm not anymore. I can't play mind games either. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, you're being generous, but okay. 3-0. Whole format was just a bad idea for my personal self-confidence, but you did well. You earned it, you deserved it, you answered pretty much all the questions. Can't say fairer than that. I'll show you my respect, yeah. You did it, good job. You are the winner this time.
Maybe cheers. We'll take the next one onto the court for tennis. Yeah. Do you like to play tennis?
I do, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, I mean...
Right, rematch on... tennis court.
We can try that, yeah. A bit more space for me to like chase things down. Yeah, I think that could work for me. Yeah, we'll do that. And then if not, golf. And then if not, never football. We'll leave that to one side. But maybe we can find one sport that I can win at. Yeah, okay,
we'll keep
perfect.
Mixing it up.
Cheers, Chris.
Perfect, pleasure.